When I started programming in Rust, I found traits a little hard to get my head around. This is because I was very used to object-oriented programming. In classic object-oriented programming, you have an object, and that object contains both data, which stores the characteristics of that object, and behavior, which consists of methods you can call on an object to use it or manipulate it. Rust does things a little differently. In Rust, we typically keep data in enums or structs, and then we keep behavior separately in traits. Traits allow different types to share the same behavior. Since the data and the behavior are kept separately, you can mix and match the behavior as you need it throughout your program. Let's go ahead and see this in action. First, let's create a person struct. And now let's create another struct. Let's call it the cat struct. And then we create a trait to use with our structs. And let's call this trait the eat trait. Both people and cats need to eat. And let's define a method in this trait called eat dinner. Notice that we don't define behavior for this method here in the trait. That comes later when we implement this trait on our types. First, let's implement it for the person type. Then we define behavior for the eat dinner method when it is called on a person. If we now create a person and then call the eat dinner method on that person, we get this output: I eat dinner from a plate. Now let's implement the eat trait on our cat struct, including defining behavior for the eat dinner method, which is different behavior than what we define for a person. Let's go ahead and create an instance of our cat struct and then call the eat dinner method on that cat. And we get this output: I eat dinner from a cat bowl. Something we can also do with our traits is define default behavior for methods in that trait. Let's go ahead and define default behavior for the eat dinner method in the trait itself. This means if I implement this trait on a struct, but I don't define behavior for the eat dinner method, this is the behavior that it will default to. Now, when we create a new struct, let's call this the rabbit struct. And then implement the eat trait on the rabbit struct. Rabbits have to eat just like people and cats. Notice that we don't specify behavior for the eat dinner method. In this case, we're just using the default behavior for that method in that trait. That means when we create an instance of a rabbit and call the eat dinner method on that rabbit, when the rabbit eats its dinner, the output is I eat from a dish. This has been a high-level overview of traits and how they are used in the Rust language. Next, we'll get into some hands-on examples of using traits in our Rust code. I'll see you in the next video.